Hello class, welcome back in the next session of computer network lab practical. So in the last session we discussed about the crossover and straight through cables and their uses. All right, so in this session we are going, then we discuss about switches. In this session we are going to explain the networking device router, and this is the last one, and to one interface Cisco IOS. After that we all will be implementing this on Cisco Packet Tracer. So before I start, let me know, am I audible? Can you see me? Can you hear me? Can you see me? Yeah, correct. Okay, let me share. Okay, fine. I have shared my people. Yeah. Block the Mac, right? If someone, it means you will not be able to use any services of that particular network. For example, in Chandigarh University, somehow I come to know about your Mac address. Yeah, you know, there is translation between, there is translation between the MAC address and the IP address. Vice versa, keep on. And I can find out the IP. IP is the logical, and MAC, that is the physical address. I can find out that. So there is a special dedicated protocol, that is ARP, address resolution protocol. Okay, if someone blocks your MAC, you won't be able to use any service of that particular network. These all are, you know, practically implemented. All right, Rabish, should we move forward? Move further? You are changing the connect karte ho kam na fine network device, that is router. So you all are aware about that. You might have seen in your home router, home, that is, you know, one kind of wireless router. Is a networking device. This is the, you know, icon on every book or practical. You will find this icon for the router. So wherever you see this icon, that represents the router. So a router is networking device that forward the data packet between computer work gateway. The router perform the traffic direction functioning on the internet. I have this is one of the, you know, main leading actor in dawn of the internet. Which dawn? D-O-N. Which dawn? Yeah, plus, can you, yeah, this is, I will show you this movie, Dawn of the Internet. In some activity class, I will show you this movie, and you will find the in the lead role is this is the router. You can, you know, allow some IP address. You can allow some IP address, right? Or you can routing table is being maintained. Right, data sent through the internet, such as web page or email, is in the form of data packet. So the packet is typically forwarded from one router to another through the network that constitute the internet work, or simply internet, until it reaches to the destination. So this is the icon I have already shown you, router. We will be providing IP address and we will configuring this also. This is the scenario topology. Maine ek topology banaya hua hai yahan pe. I have made one topology here. This is the scene one or case study one. This is Wi-Fi wireless home router. Yeah, this one. Let me change the color of the ink. Which color? Any color. Right. So I am having a laptop. A laptop is Wi-Fi supported, so it will be hooked up with this router. This is the easiest one. You are also having a smartphone. A smartphone also support Wi-Fi. This will be hooked up to the router. And I am having a old PC, personal computer. So yeah, I have to connect it with wire. So anyone, let me know which cable you will use for this purpose. Which one should I repeat? Anyone? A straight cable, because Wi-Fi router is one type, a PC is another type. So wherever the Wi-Fi is supported, no wire is needed, and there, yeah, correct answer, straight through cable. Now this is scene one, case study one. This is scene two. So after, you know, this COVID pandemic, or you know, after your long break, you are returning to, you know, class. So Himanshu having lots of movie in his laptop, almost, you know, you can say 50 GB. He wanna share it with Ravish, right? So they say, yeah, Himanshu say, yeah, Ravish, I have one cable, right? I have one cable. So yeah, 50 GB not possible to send over internet because it will consume too much time. So let's connect our laptop. This will be a peer-to-peer. Again, question. For these two friend will be sharing which cable? The two friends are Himanshu and Ravish. This is the cross cable. Aur kaun sa version rahe to better hoga? Which version, which category? Yeah, absolutely fine. In Chandigarh University you can find category 6, the one in green color. The one in green color that I have shown you. So what is the next agla task kya hoga? What will be the, you will set a IP address of any class, because it is, you know, it is a LAN, local area networking. You set a IP1, you set a IP2, and you will directly able to send, share your file. All right, the networking. But here you have to see. The first one that we see is, you know, DHCP. That is automatically, you are having your home router, then on browser you are given a login. You can configure, you can give IP address to this router, then you can also configure its subnet mask and all. So what, whether it will be static or dynamic? Static means you by yourself providing the IP address to your laptop, you by yourself providing. the IP address to this laptop, smartphone, or this PC, or the printer. You have one, you know, printer also. You can connect this. Printer and which cable for printer and Wi-Fi router? Now we have to implement this in packet tracer. This is the real life scenario. Take a screenshot. We will implement that. Okay, fine. You say that between, you know, 10 to between 10 to 40 assign the IP address. So it will automatically assign to your laptop, to your mobile phone. This is the easiest one, most common scenario that you see. 99% chance the IP address is automatically assigned. Isn't? Agree? 99%. But here, this assigned by the router. Have you used that? Anyone? How in the home? How many of you are using that in a small office also? Soho. In Soho, take the screenshot. We're gonna implement that in packet tracer. We're gonna simulate that. The two scenario, the point-to-point connection, and the home router also. All right. Any doubt? Yes. Yeah, Ravish, which thing I should repeat? Which topic? There are two case study that I have given. Number one, we will be implementing. Now, you all are answering which cable, straight through cable, crossover cable, you know IP addresses, you know how to configure that. You know the router also. Yeah, difference between, yeah, 0 to 40. That IP address will be, automatically assigned between that range. You don't need to give it manually. If you are providing manually, then it is static. If it is automatically assigned by this DHCP protocol. Okay, now let's take up the question of Himanshu. Modem and router. Basically, you know, modem serve for the purpose of modulation and demodulation. Basically, it convert the analog signal to the digital one and digital to the analog. That's it. You are accessing internet, but this cable, the Ethernet cable, capable of carrying only the analog signal, that telephone line over on all that. They convert the data in the form of zero and one. In the form of signal. So now how it is converted into digital so that your communicating device may understand. All right. Now, this is the Cisco router from real life. This is the Cisco 1900 series router by Cisco. You can see here various ports, power, cable that is used to connect. This is of Cisco 1921 model. The power button. So how you gonna provide configure IP in your router? How you gonna configure? Let me quickly finish that. So the answer of this, that you are provided an interface. You are given interface. This is the last topic of case study. This is the Cisco IOS, the study of all the networking devices. So Cisco IOS basically is a command line interface. Yeah, there are two interfaces. One is the GUI, where you done everything, you know, by graphical user interface. Then there is CLI, command line interface. That is basically provided by nearly all the Cisco router and switches. In home router also, in web browser, you are provided interface from where you can set the IP for that particular router. Next, this Cisco IOS was formerly the network inter-network operating system. Is a family of network operating system, Cisco IOS, that is used on many Cisco system router and current Cisco network and switches. So earlier Cisco switches ran on CatOS, now it is running on Cisco IOS. So Cisco IOS is a package. In single line, if you want to define, Cisco IOS is a package of routing, switching, internet working, and telecommunication function integrated into multitasking operating system. So although the IOS code base include the cooperative multitasking kernel, most IOS feature have been ported to other kernels such as QNX and Linux for use in Cisco product. So this was the interface. You can also see this interface in CLI and GUI both in Cisco Packet Tracer, CPT. That's all about all the study. Thank you very much. Now I will be dividing you all in various group. Okay. So see how much we have covered in this experiment number one. This was the study of. Now let us see how much we have already covered. Let me come to home. So what was the order? First we covered IP. In IP we also covered subnet mask. Then we covered the classes of IP. To sum up, classes of IP, then we saw some special IP addresses that are reserved. This what topic was, you know, quite lengthy, special, some, you know, then private IP addresses. Then after IP, you are supposed to deploy your devices. Then after deploying the devices, you need to decide about the cable, which cable you will be using and which connector are there. So this was the third order. Then after discussing crossover RJ45-3 topics, then we discuss about layer 2 switch, then router, then Cisco IOS interface. So third, fourth, fifth, this is the order. So that's all. So how you will be submitting worksheet 1? See the task 1, task 2, but before the task 1, task 2, you have to briefly describe in 4 to 5 lines about IP. Okay, fine. Let me cover one more topic. Agar aap logon ne class padh liya IP address ka, you all have gone through the classes of IP A, B, C, D and all. This is known as classful IP, right? So the one topic is already, you know, covered in that, classless. So I hope it's clear that how you will be. I was, you know, receiving many question regarding to extend the date of the worksheet 1 because I hadn't, we haven't completed the Cisco IOS, the layer 2 switch router, and this is the most very very important. This will decide whether you can ping This will decide whether you can ping a particular IP 192.168.1.10. Then here 192.168.1.11. So your selection of the cable, that also how you are connecting to which port, that will decide whether you are able to ping a particular IP or not. So यहाँ पे मैं आप लोगों से दो क्वेश्चन पूछ सकता हूँ. आई कैन आस्क टू क्वेश्चन 192.168.1.11. सो वट इज द पर्पज ऑफ दिस पिंग कमांड. सो इफ यू हैव सबमिटेड देन नो इशू इन दिस ऑर्डर दैट आई एम आस्किंग. इफ यू हैवंट सबमिटेड then you can resubmit. I will consider it. That's all from my side. Now I'm going to have a breakout session and I will be conducting okay. You all will be divided into various groups. I will come and ask question to you all. Fine, agree, let me know. You are you there? Okay, quickly let me know. Now I'm not going to explain anything. You all will be divided into various group. And what should I display on PPT? The one IP address covered, subnet mask covered, class A, B, C, D, E, then private, some special, summary, problem with the classful addressing. Yeah, there is some problem with the classful addressing, and year 1993 onward there is a new term, that is classless inter-domain routing, that we will discuss later on. So here it is. Divide here. I am stopping here. See this scenario. Try to simulate. Have you all installed packet tracer on your machine? Now we will be doing practical. We have all the background knowledge. Have you all installed packet tracer? Cisco packet tracer. I hope you all have downloaded and installed from the official site of Cisco, that is Cisco Net Acad. So if you haven't, so do download and install. Fine.